surpass my opponent. I do know that once I defeat him, there will be a title shot coming. But what comes first is Adrian Broner. I take him down in a situational match, and then it's all up to him.
Thank you, Jason.
No problem.
Hey,
how you doing?
So, I hear you're doing a lot of work for Spring Mountain Youth Camp.
I am. I always like staying very involved with the youth here in the community, and we try to help out in any way possible. We try to give them positive tips of being a positive role model, showing them how we got to this position. I feel that that's very important, by leading by example, showing them and explaining to them how we made it through. Because some of the kids just make mistakes, and we all make mistakes sometimes. But I want to make sure to let them know that they can continue to progress from the situation that they're in. And it's just by explaining how they can do it, giving them different options and helping them out when they come back down to the city as well.
Did you do anything different for this upcoming fight?
Yeah, I did. I actually added a nutritionist. I should have done that years ago, but better late than never. And it's actually benefited me very much. I feel stronger. I feel with plenty of energy throughout my training camp. And I've always throughout this training camp, that's the same emotion that I've had, the same energy that I maintained. And it's benefited me a lot. I feel that we're going to be victorious and we're going to win in a sensational fashion because of that. You have to have people that know their different science, around the sport. I have my boxing trainer, I have a strength and conditioning coach, now I have a nutritionist. We have a great team behind us, a great promoter, advisor, Al Heyman, Juan Valencia. We have a good team together.
So you're totally a Vegas local, Vegas royalty. What do you have to say to your fans?
Well, first of all, I want to thank my fans for supporting me throughout the years. And I know that